Good morning students, welcome to your computer class. Today's class we will start with variable, which already you have learned in class 9. So what is variable? It is a temporary reserved memory area that can store different values during the program execution. It is a named memory location which can hold data value of a particular data type. That means variable must have a name and a specific data type. Variable name is used to access and manipulate the value of a variable. The value of a variable can be changed during the course of the program execution. That's why the name is variable. Now, how to declare variable in a program? The declaration syntax is access specifier, modifier, data type, variable name, equal to value, semicolon. So, equal to value and access specifier, modifier, these are optional. We may use, may not use. Access specifier means either public, private or protected. Then modifier can be static and data type is must. It can be any valid Java data type, either primitive type or non-primitive type. If we use primitive data type, that means we can store value to a variable. And if we write non-primitive data type as a data type for the variable, that means that variable is reference type, where we can store memory reference. And then equal to value. This equal to value is an assignment statement where we are initializing the variable at the time of its declaration. Value means literal or constant, which already we have learned in our previous class. And if we don't assign value at the time of declaration, we will end the variable name with semicolon. Now constant already we have learned, but today we will learn another thing, that is named constant, which is just like a variable, but it is a final variable. So named constant is a temporary reserved memory area just like variable, but it can store a static value which cannot be changed during the course of the program execution. So named constants are implemented through the use of final keyword. This final keyword indicates that the initial value of the variable is final and it prevents that value from being modified. That means in the declaration statement only one word we have to insert before the data type, that is final keyword. As it is keyword, we have to write that keyword in small letter. And here that value is essential. That means at the time of declaration of the named constant, you have to initialize that named constant and that value will be the final value for the named constant. That means that value's name actually we are giving. Whenever we will take the name of the named constant, its value will be used, which cannot be changed. Okay. Now we will discuss about tokens of Java. Tokens are elements or components of a Java program. They implement various program features in a program. 5 tokens are there in Java: keyword, identifier, literal, separator, and operator. So one by one we will discuss all these tokens. First, identifier. This is what? Name of different program elements. They represent variable, method, class, object, array, constant, etc. At the time of giving a name to any programming element, we have to follow certain rules. What are the rules? They must start with a letter or underscore or dollar sign, but can contain any set of alphabets, digits, underscore or dollar symbol. So we cannot use any other symbol other than dollar and underscore. And it should not start with digit. Digit may come after the first character. And it cannot contain any embedded space also. And few conventions also you have to follow. That is, the identifier should be meaningful, whether it is variable name or function name or class name. Class name means what concept you are representing through class, that name you give. Function name is what functionality the function is providing, that name you give. Variable name, what value it is storing, that name you give. Like to store your name, give the name of the variable name. To store your age, give the name as age. To store your marks, give the name marks. For function, if it is calculating the sum, you give the name sum. If it is generating series, give the name series. And for class, suppose it is representing BART, you give the class name as BART. If it is representing student, give the name student. Understood? Next comes keyword. Keywords are the reserved word in Java which express the language features. Keywords specify a particular task in a program and cannot be used as an identifier. Keywords are always written in lowercase letters. Example of keywords: class, for, int, public, switch, default, these all are keywords. So we cannot use this keyword for any variable's name, class name or function name. Then literal. Literal already we have discussed in our previous class, so no more discussion about literal. Now next token is separator. So as the name suggested, separator is a special character in Java which behaves as punctuation in Java. Separators are used to separate one element from another in a program. Different separators used in Java programs are first bracket, open, close, set, curly braces, second brackets, third brackets, comma, full stop, semicolon. These all are separators. And last one is operator. It's very important. The operators are special symbols or sometimes words used to perform some operation on Java data. Operators can be of three types based on the number of operand they work on: unary operator, binary operator, and ternary operator. Unary for single operand. It works on single value or single operand. It can be a value or variable. Like plus plus, minus minus, plus, minus, exclamation, tilde symbol. These all are unary operator. Then binary operator. Most of the Java operators are binary operator because they work on two values. Like plus, sum of two numbers. Star to calculate the product. All relational operator, greater than, less than, not equal to, equal to, equal to, logical operator, not, and, or, they are binary operators. And last one is ternary operator. In Java, only one ternary operator is there. That is also called conditional operator, because this operator is used to check one condition and takes decision just like if-else statement. The operator is question colon. It works on three operands. One operand before question, then another operand after question, and then colon after colon, the last operand. Here the first operand is the condition which will be checked using question, and if the condition is true, the second operand which is between question and colon will be executed, and if the condition is false, the last operand or expression will be executed. That means the value of this full expression will be either second operand or third operand based on the condition. If the condition is evaluated to true, then the second operand will be the value of the expression. If the condition is false, the last operand will be the value of this expression. Understood? In Java, different operators are arithmetic operators, relational operators, logical operators, assignment operator, increment decrement operator, conditional operator, bitwise operator, shift operator, and special operators. So arithmetic operator. So we know that five arithmetic operators are there: plus, minus, star, slash, and modulus. And their functions also you know. No need to tell again. Then relational operator. It checks the relation of two numbers or characters: greater than, less than, greater than equal to, less than equal to, not equal to, and equal to equal to. So here, how to write greater than equal to or less than equal to? Greater than or less than followed by equal to symbol, not like the symbol we use in maths. And here not equal to symbol is exclamation equal to. In Java, exclamation means not, and equal to equal to for relational equal to operator, which checks the equality of two numbers. All these relational operators, they return either true or false, but they work on integer or character value. Next is logical operator. Logical operator in true sense, they work on logical value, means on true false, and they return also logical value true false. Three logical operators are there: not, and or. Not means exclamation, we know. And operator is two ampersand, and or operator is two vertical broken bar. Next is assignment operator. One single equal to operator. This is used to assign a value to a variable. Means the value which is specified at the right hand side of the equal to symbol will be assigned to the variable which is specified at the left hand side of the equal to symbol. The value can be a literal or a calculated value. Now this single assignment operator can combine with five arithmetic operator to make another category called arithmetic assignment operator: plus equal to, minus equal to, star equal to, slash equal to, and modulus equal to. All these arithmetic assignment operators are binary operators. So plus equal to means plus equal to. Plus is coming before equal to. That means plus will work first, then equal to will work. So a plus equal to 2. So a is a variable and 2 is second operand. How it works? Java interprets this expression as a equal to a plus 2. That means if the value of a is 10, then that 10 plus 2 will be the new value of a. Means actually we are increasing the value of a by 2. If we write a modulus equal to 3, it will be interpreted as a equal to a modulus 3. A's value is 10, 10 modulus 3 for remainder is 1, so a's value will be updated with 1. Clear? Next is increment-decrement operator. Two increment-decrement operators are there. One is plus plus, another one is minus minus. Plus plus is increment operator, minus minus is decrement operator. They are unary operator. Now this operator may come either before variable or after variable. If plus plus and minus minus comes before variable, means the value of the variable will be updated first, and if it is a part of an expression, then that updated value will be used in the expression. And if this plus plus and minus minus comes after the variable, then the value of the variable will be used in the expression first, and after that their values will be updated. When it comes before, it will work first. When it comes after, it will work last. Pre-increment or pre-decrement means first update, then change. And post increment and post decrement means first the value of the variable will be used, then the value will be updated. Understood? Now next one is conditional operator, which is ternary operator, question colon. Already we have discussed about that. Now three more categories are there: bitwise operators, shift operators, and special operators. About these operators, we will learn later. So today no more, up to this much. See you in our next class, when we will continue with these three types of operators. Till then, bye. Have a nice day.